Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Code with Sunny, and in this video I am going to talk about the problem ambiguous coordinates, index number is 816, and the problem is of one of the medium type problems of the lead code. Okay, so this is this problem is categorized into the medium type, and the reason behind is quite much simple. Whenever the some question related to backtracking or recursive solution comes up, it like it automatically transfers into the category of medium. I don't think so, but if you are aware of the concepts of backtracking or something like that, then you will like if familiar with that, then you can easily solve this problem. So you can easily see the constraints are like string's length is maximum 12. So in that case, you must think for a recursive solution because this constraint is quite very much small. Even O of n power 4 would be like 12 power 4. It should be around 10 power 4 or yes, it should be around 10 power 4. So you must think of a recursive solution concept like of backtracking. Okay, so let's first discuss this problem and we will together find it out what could be the best solution of this problem. So we had two dimensional coordinates like this one or this one, and then we are going to remove all the commas, decimal points and the spaces, and we are going to end up with a string s. And what type of string s? You can easily see these types. If you are going to remove all the commas or the spaces between the strings, the characters, like if you remove comma from here and the space, it would become like bracket, opening bracket, 1 3 closing bracket. Okay, and we have to return a list of strings representing all possibilities for what our original coordinates could have been. Okay, that could be challenging problem. No, it doesn't be, it is not like a challenging problem. Okay, let us first do read over that. Our original representation never had extraneous zeros. It means that you are not considering like such number of zeros should be like more than the expected. I will explain what is the basically meaning and significance of these statements. Like if we start with double zero, that is, you can see I can represent that is this string is double zero. I can compress this double zero to single zero. That is, there is one extraneous zero present over this string. And you can also see these type of strings are going to be invalid, like 0.0. I can represent this 0.0 to 0 also. I can also represent 0.00 to 0. Like 0 simply. I can also represent 1.0 to 1 itself, so this is not valid. I can also represent this string like 001 to 1 also, so this is invalid. I can also represent 00.01 as 0.1, so this is invalid. Or any other number that can be represented with less digits. Okay, so overall this statement is basically signifying that if you have some certain string and if you convert that string into numerical form, then you must think about that if that total number of characters present in that string must be equal to total number of digits present in that numerical form. That is numerical form of it, then you can easily say yes, it is a valid string, otherwise it is not valid. In other words, you can easily say I can compress this double zero. If you write numerical form of this string, it would become single zero, so this is not valid, and similarly others. So we will take care that we should not allow these type of strings. Okay, also a decimal point with a number never occurs without at least one digit, so we are never going to start with this dot minus one. Yes, this is also not valid. If we occur with such type of strings, then it is also like it should be eradicated from to our answers. Okay, so final answer list can be returned in any order. We have to return that list. Okay, so return the coordinates. You can easily see if I have 1 2 3, I can put comma over any over the any like any after any characters, like after one, then 1, 2, 3, then I can also put a comma after that, 12, 3, I think. Then I can put a comma after 2 and put a dot between 1 and 2, 1.2, 3, and similarly this one. Okay, so I will try to explain what could be the best solution of this problem and how to build up the idea related to this problem in detail. So let's move further. Okay, so I am considering one example, like if I have a string like 0000, 1 1. Okay, so consider this example. Now it means that there is a comma that has been eradicated between these. Any that is comma can be present anywhere over these characters, after any characters, like comma can be present over here, comma can be present over here, it can be present over here, it can be present over here. Okay, so I'm just trying to just make the substrings of this string. And what are those substrings of this strings? That is, I'm just dividing this string into two parts. That is, it is obvious that comma is present after any character. Let's say after this first character. So I will divide my this string into two substrings of this type. That is, first one would be like 0. Okay, I would write over here. First one would be like 0, followed by this 0, 0, 1, 1. Then again, I will divide my string of this type. That is, I'm going to take first two characters in my first substring, followed by the remaining characters. It should be like, okay, so you must consider that I have just divided over here. Okay, so this is my first substring and this is my second substring of the very first type. Okay, so don't get confused over that. Okay, now I'm just taking two characters. It is like 00 followed by 011. Again, I will take three characters, so it would be like 000 followed by the rest of the characters. It would be like 11. Then I will come over like 0001 and this one character. And I cannot just put over the comma after this one. So I'm just not considering that. I'm just going to take all the five characters to the first substring. This is going to be invalid. So these are the pair of like substrings where the comma can be placed. Like comma can be placed after first character, after taking two characters in my first substring, and so on. Now the question lies that we have just put it over the comma, that we must take care that we must put a dot, that is a decimal point. Can we put a decimal point over these strings? Like if we try to pick up this 11, then I can easily put a dot over between this one. This is 1.1 and this is a valid string according to the definition of this one. Okay, so this is a valid. So I just need to try to put a dot over every pair of strings for every division. That is, if I am considering this division, I will try to figure it out from where I can put a dot over every substring. That is this first substring and this second substring. Okay, so that is okay. I'm just doing one example. Suppose I have this first division, that is 0 and 0011. Then that is first substring will contain 0. So I will try all possible pairs where this dot can be pushed so that we have a valid string consisting of a numerical digit. Okay, so you can easily see there is only single number. I cannot put a dot over any like 0. And after it is like null. I cannot do that. Also, I cannot do that like 0.0. So this is invalid. So my only one number that is coming out to be valid from the first substring would be like only 0. So let us try to consider for the second one like 0, 0, 1, 1. I will try to put a dot over here. That is dot over any of the positions. Okay. So let us try to put a dot over there like dot 0011. You can easily see this is invalid according to the definition. This doesn't give a numerical digit, so I'm not considering this one. So this is removed. Then I'm just trying to put a dot over here. 0.011. This is valid or not? Yes, this is valid. So I'm just taking this string. Note that this a string without any dot is also valid. That is 0. Okay. So 0011 is also valid and 0.011 is also valid. And let us try to put more dots over here like 0.11. Is this valid? No, it is not valid. I can represent this like removing my extra zeros like over here. I can represent this like 0.11. This should be valid. This is not valid. So I'm not considering this string. Okay, so let me erase this one. Okay. So let us try to put more dots over here like 0, 0 and 1.1. You can easily see this is also invalid. And let me try to put dot over this one. This is also invalid. So I must not consider these type of strings. So what I am going to consider for this division is only these type of strings. Like only would be like 0 for the first substring and this 2 for the second substring, and this is valid. Okay, so similarly I will try to match up every pairs, like this 0 can be matched up with this pair or this 0 can be matched up with this pair. Okay, so let us try to figure it out that as I've already explained how to like put a comma after every substring, that is first take a single substring with single character, then substring with two characters, then substring with three characters, and then substring with four characters, and so on. Okay, then I will try to explain how to put a dot over between these strings to find out total number of possible coordinates. Let us try to understand this in detail, because this is going to be like very much key point or confusing point of this problem, where to put dot and where not to put a dot, because the statements are like very clumsy type. So let us try to understand this in detail part. Okay, so consider this string like this one, 00011. As I have already said, I will try to make partitions over there. Let's say I have first substring as only triple, single 0, and my second substring as 0011. Okay, so don't get confused, only this is the pairs of substring that we can divide. We can divide like put a comma over everywhere. Okay, I think I've missed something like in the previous one. Okay, so don't consider this as to our answer. That is, I can represent this number, this string format number with the by eradicating some zeros. Like it should be like 11. 11 is the like best way to represent this number, and these zeros are extra. So I'm just erasing this one stuff. Like don't use this number. That is for every partition. Just try to check. If I will try to put dot over everyone, that is either don't try to put dot over any of the after any of the characters, or try to put dot after one character, then next. You can easily see this is valid 0.011, but this 0011 is not valid because this is actually 11, and these two zeros are appended to the beginning as an extra. So I'm not going to consider these characters. So only character that should be considered is from the left part of this substring would be, that is from first substring at 0 and second would be like 0.011 for this one. Okay, so let us try to talk about this one, that is 0 and h2 equals 0011. Okay, that is I'm just trying to just write it down for any general string s. Suppose s is any general string of length n. And we will try to put a decimal point after every character, that is after first character, after second character, and we'll try to find out all the possible numbers that we can find. Then from S1 there are X possible numbers, then we have S2 that will have Y possible numbers, and total number of possible coordinates would be like X into Y, and we will try to print all the possible coordinates. So for S, so for any general string of length n, what could be like a valid decimal point from where we are going to put off? Okay, so let's say n is going to be like, okay, length of string s. Okay, so suppose if n is going to be 1, I'm just trying to write down, if n is going to be 1, then you can easily see that the string would be of like type s would be like 0. Or s would be any of 1, or s would be on yes, it is either 0 or either 1. Then in that case, what could be my valid total number of numerical strings that is going to be valid? That is, I cannot put a 1 point something like that, I cannot put a 0 point something like that. So valid string would be like only this string s. So I will return the s, that is my total number of strings valid would be only s. Okay, so and after this is done, it is obvious that a string's length for a particular division, that is for a particular substring, would be always greater than 1. Okay, so I'm just talking about now for the greater than 1 string length. Okay, so if that is already we have configured that n is going to be like greater than 1, so if my first character is also 0 and my second character, or let's say the last character, I think last character is also 0, it means that we need to find a strings would be of type, like let's say it is obvious that length is going to be like greater than 1, so it would be of type 0, 1, 1, 0, or like there can be many type. I'm just trying to have a brief overview of like 0, 0, so it can be of this type. You can easily see if I will have the strings of this type, what could be my answer. If you can easily see, I can just eradicate this extra zeros that is present over the beginning and present over the end. In that case, my answer would be like null. I cannot have any valid strings. Even if you took original string without putting any dot, like only this string, I can just easily compress this string to only 0. And also, I can easily compress this string to only 11. So, I will return an empty value. Okay, so like I'm just trying to write the base cases when this situation comes up, and I will also try to write a general one also after covering this base case, otherwise we will get the error in our answers. Okay, so let us try to write down for like if ending character and the beginning character both are 0, then we will have to return this one. And let us try to write down if my ending character is only 0. And it is obvious that after the execution goes on, this when this condition of if else comes up, it means that only the beginning character is going to be like 0 and ending character is non-zero and string length is greater than 1. Now consider the example of this type, like s is exactly equal to 0 and it is only 0, then it will have 1 1. Or consider s as an example of okay, like 0 0 1 1. So in these type of strings, that is only the beginning character is 0 and ending character is non-zero, and the string's length is greater than 1. You can easily see I will have the answer. Total number possible words would be like only the words of type 0.111 or 0.0111 or 0. Something random number like 0110. It is going to be like this is not valid because the ending character and the beginning character both are 0. This doesn't come into our category. So I can have like this character. So the only character that is possible is after that you put a dot, put a decimal point after the first character. So I will return the string consists of only 0, 0 dot plus string substring starting from 1. This is going to be like a valid one. And what about this ending character is only 0? Okay, so if beginning character is 0, it is done. And if ending character is also 0, it is done. And if only beginning character is 0, it is done. And let's talk about only ending character, which is 0. Okay, how we are going to do that? Okay, so though it is very simple. We have the strings of like this type, s equals 1110, or because the ending character does not match with the beginning character and it should not be 0, or I will have the character like s of like 1110010. Okay, so you can easily see we have the characters of this type. So if you try to put a 0 over here, like okay, so I will try to just show you how it is going to be done. So it becomes like 111.0, or it would become 11.10, or it would become 11100, or like 0.10. Okay, so when you have the strings of this type, you can always see that after the decimal point, or you can see after the decimal point, that is the substring present over there, the ending character is always going to be there. We can always compress this string, remove that ending as a character, which is 0. And you can always have a string having the smaller numerical value and has number of digits going to be like less than the number of digits present over these strings. Okay, so in this case, the only character that is possible is the character given, that is only string that is possible over here is the string itself, like this one. We'll return the string itself as an answer. Okay, and now every base case is covered. Now we will try to put a dot over after every character, that is the first character I have taken, then the first two characters I have taken, then the first three characters I have taken, and we'll try to put a dot and then we'll return over there. Okay, So how I'm going to do that? So it is going to be like very simple. Consider this as a string. So let's say I have s equals, okay, I'm just moving it down. So let's say I have the string s over here, like if such characters matches like 011, okay, then I will try to put a dot over here. Okay, let's say I'm not over here 0. Okay, so I will try to put a dot, like 1 dot this one, or it should be like 11 dot 111. I think I should have to put 1 over here, and it can be like 11 triple 1 dot 11, it can be like 41 dot 11, and so on. We are going to put dot over one by one, and these are the four pairs of strings. And similarly for the first substring, and similarly for the second substring, we will try to form the total number of coordinates over there, and then we will return the answer. Okay, so let's try to discuss this code, and we will together find out if there exist any doubts. You can easily see I first get an accepted verdict, then I try to improve my runtime complexity of this code, then finally I have reached over this one. The complexity having runtime beats 95.74% of CPP submissions. Okay, so you can easily see I have taken a string's length, and I have also taken my answer vector of strings, array of strings. Then what I have done is I have just tried to just take the substring of my original string. That is, first I have divided on the basis of comma. Okay, so you can easily see that string A would consist of I will pass an argument to this possible function. The first string, that is s dot subst here, is up to the ith that ith index. That is, let's suppose I have the comma after this ith character, and the remaining substrings after that. Okay, so it would be going to be like we have two total set of possible like strings in the A and total set of possible strings in the B. I will try to form the coordinates. That is, for every word in this string A, I try to append this coordinate, and the coordinate should be like ch1 plus this comma, that is after this ith character, plus this ch2 for every word of the string A, and that is vector of string A, and for every word of this vector of string B. And we will try to return the coordinate, total number of possible coordinates. And the main thing that is playing a vital role over here is possible function. It will return total number of possible strings, valid strings, where we can put a comma over here after passing a suitable parameter over this. Okay, so let us try to discuss this possible function. So I have this n as string's length, vector string stored, and if n is going to even return as it is, because the only possible string that should be included in our answer as the numerical value would be one, that is the string itself. And if first character is 0 and the last one is also 0, we are going to return null. That is, no character is going to be pushed in this case, or no string is going to be a valid string in this case. And that is, here you can also see n is going to be like greater than 1, because for n equal to 1 I have already checked and returned. And this also, only the first character is going to be like 0. Just put a dot 0 point and the remaining characters. And similarly, if last character is 0 and the first character is non-zero and the string's length is going to be like greater than 1, then put out the string s as it is and return. Otherwise, put a dot between the digits. Okay, so I will take a start as empty, and I will take a reverse as the entire string, and each time I will push a character of this string s into my start and erase a character from the beginning of this reverse string. Okay, so you can easily see my answer would be like pushed back my like original string without any dot. Okay, without any dot. Yes, it is right, without any dot. Okay, so after that I have just taken this start, appended any character, that is ith character, from this string s, and from this reverse, which is actually the initialized with the entire string, is deleted by every character, that is from the beginning ones. Okay, and I will push back this thing, start plus a dot, the decimal point, plus this reverse. Okay, and finally I've returned this store consisting of all possible valid substrings where this comma dot can be placed. Okay, so this is for every particular substring, and I'm going to do this, call this possible function for the substring up to the ith character, and put a comma over here, and then the substring for this after this comma, that is after this ith character, and we will have some possible strings A and some possible strings B, valid strings of numerical values, and we'll try to find out the total number of possible coordinates by taking their intersection, or you can say the total number of possible strings. Like for every string present in A, we have some string in B, so I will push back the common thing, that is character 1 plus a common plus a comma plus character 2. This is going to be like total number of valid answers, and finally return the answer. This will give us a runtime weights of 95.74%. So if you have any doubts, do let me know in the comment section of the video, and I will ask the viewers to like this video, share this video, and to subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you for watching this video.